going on, everybody? Welcome to my channel today. I just wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about, you know it, Klinefelter syndrome, also known as 47XXY, and give you guys a new statistic that I recently was exposed to. So I went to Denver in June, which was my first Access conference. Met some amazing people that have Klinefelter syndrome. Never met anybody in my life that had it, and it really inspired me to start talking about it openly. I've always been open, but talking about it openly to the world through a video camera. So this statistic is, there are 4 million babies being born each year in the United States, and of those 4 million, 1 in 400 will have Klinefelter syndrome, which means that's 40,000. So each year, 40,000 kids have Klinefelter syndrome. Only 30% will know, and the other 70% will never know in their entire life. So let's break that down. 30% of 40,000, 12,000. So 12,000 kids will know, whether before they're born, in high school, later on in life, or really late in life. And the other 28,000, which is the 70%, will never know in their entire life. And which to me is that the fact that it's 30-70 is a really big red flag to me, and one of the reasons why I started making these videos. And basically, if we can help spread awareness and open up about ourselves having Klinefelter and our kids having it, and talking to other people and spreading the word, because spreading the word vocally through voice is the best way to do it. Maybe we can help those 70%. And if we help that 70% and bring it down to maybe 50 or 40%, imagine what that could do for the whole society itself. We could help build a better community. We can help raise more money, because the more people that understand it and know about it, the more parents, the more people, the more grandmothers, aunts, uncles, friends will donate money for research. And the more research we have, the better products that they could come out for us later on in life. I mean, I don't know about you guys, but I've been injecting testosterone in my right butt cheek, my left butt cheek, my thighs for 20 years. And it'd be awesome in the next 10 years or something to have different methods, or just have more research and more money and more funding for the nonprofits out there. So that's kind of like my two cents on it. I know that a lot of people will say, well, the statistic is 1 in 500 or 1 in 800 or 1 in 1,000. I'm just going off of what I heard. So, you know, all we got to do is continue to be open-minded and tell people what Klinefelter syndrome really is, from the good about it, and, you know, really let people know that what they read on Wikipedia and WebMD and just on the internet in general is a very, like, clinical research doctor perspective about the syndrome. And yes, those are very important, because you have to be able to diagnose the syndrome, but at the same time, that diagnosis doesn't make me who I am. It might hinder some of my things that I might be good at, or not being able to have kids and being sterile is that big one, but I'm not gonna let that stop me from living my life and being positive, being happy, and being able to hike solo in the woods and enjoy myself. So just keep staying positive and keep being that train that could continue to climb that mountain, and I'll be talking to you guys soon. Hope all is well, and yeah, that's about it. This isn't perfect. This is just me talking to the camera and reaching out to the entire world. So bye, guys.